Before starting our presentation, let me introduce myself. My name is Tita Rahayu. By the way, here I'm not alone. Let me introduce my friend. It's the first one. She is Cinta Nur Farida. And then, Widya Rahmati. Well guys, in this presentation, we are going to discuss about hardware on the computer. The purpose of our presentation to find what can learn from the computer hardware. What do you think about computer hardware? Okay guys, hardware basically has a non-physical part called firmware. Firmware serves as the basic provider instruction that can be performed by hardware. Firmware is stored on a special memory chip on chip hardware, which can be the ROM or EEPROM ROM. Firmware is a small piece of software that is usually written an inferior programming language to quickly produce basic instruction that can be used by the hardware. This basic instruction can be divided into three, namely, number one, basic instruction for input. Basic input instruction are instructions that can provide information to other software, namely the operating system with intermediate drivers. This happens when the user interacts with the hardware in question, for example, typing with the keyboard, moving the mouse, and others. Number two, basic process instruction. Process instruction for the input or output process carried out by hardware. Basic process instruction in question are instructions that only occur in hardware or not in a complete computer system. And then number three, basic output instruction. Output basic instruction that are called by other software, namely the operating system with intermediate drivers. This happens when there is common to use the hardware from this. For example, playing videos with a monitor, printing document with a printer, and others. Well, next material about the type and function of computer hardware that will be presented by my friend, namely Cinta Nur Farida.
Thank you, Tita Rahayu, for giving me the opportunity to give an explanation about the types of computer hardware and their function. Yes, the computer system consists of five types of hardware, namely input hardware, output hardware, process hardware, storage hardware, and electrical hardware. The five hardware devices are arranged in such a way as to form an integrated system to able to input, process, and output data. Here is each explanation of the three hardware devices. 1. Hardware input. Hardware input is a type of hardware that functions to enter data or input into the computer system memory. The main input hardware of a computer system is a keyboard. A mouse is the supporting input hardware of a computer system. Here are some examples of input hardware on a computer keyboard. The keyboard is the main input device for a computer system, which consists of buttons for operating the computer. The keyboard can be used to input data as a whole on a computer system. Mouse. A mouse is the computer device that is used to input data in the form of cursor movement, clicks, and scroll. The scanner. Scanner is input hardware on a computer with input data in the form of scan a document like a photocopy. ROM drive is an input hardware device that can read input data from digital pieces in the form of CD or DVD. The device is usually used to install an operating system or software. The second is process hardware. Process hardware is a type of hardware that functions to process data or execute commands on stuck enter. The main processing hardware of a computer system is the processor, or separately VGA, sound card, and motherboard. Well, Sri Rosita will deliver an explanation of the hardware process. Thank you.
Thanks, Sintanu Farida, for the opportunity. Just here, I will complain about the hardware processor. The processor is the main process hardware, which is an electronic circuit component that can perform computational execution of logic, arithmetic control system, and specific input or output based on user order instruction. Almost processes in a computer system are carried out by the processor. The processor is also called the CPU, Central Processing Unit. Motherboard is hardware in the form of a circuit board that combines every patch of hardware in a computer system is equipped with a BIOS chip, Basic Input-Output System. This device is also called the motherboard or mainboard. There are many ports on the motherboard for connecting various hardware in a computer. FGI, Video Graphic Array, is hardware used to visualize data graphics from the very rapid development of FGI support the development of the gaming and CID industry. Sound card is the hardware is used to process data in the form of sound recording sound. The third is the output hardware. Output hardware is a type of hardware that function display to product output from process data. The main output hardware of a system is a monitor and speaker. The monitor is an output device that is used to display the result of graphic data processing from FGA. The data displayed provides information in the form of a video. Speakers in an output device is used to produce sound card processing result. Printer. A printer is output device that is used to print paper. Alright, that's the explanation from me. Furthermore, Widya Rahmawati will deliver an explanation of storage, hardware, and electric.
Thank you so much, Rosika. Well, good people, here I will tell about storage hardware and electrical. First, the storage hardware. Storage hardware is a type of hardware that functions to store user data. There are two main storage hardware of a computer system, namely internal non-volatile storage or HDD or SSD, and volatile storage or RAM. RAM, random access memory, is the volatile storage medium. Data is lost when the power is turned off, and data is accessed randomly. RAM, or random access memory, is used to store data as it is processed by the processor, because it uses DRAM technology. The RAM data transfer process reaches hundreds or even thousands of times faster than ordinary hard drives, so that to increase performance, the data processed by the processor will be stored in RAM temporarily. RAM is also used for caching technology, which is to store temporary files. For example, when opening an application, it feels slow, but the second time around, it will feel fast. This happens because RAM has stored application data for processing if needed, which is known as caching. ROM, read-only memory, is a non-volatile storage medium. Data is not lost when the power is turned off, and is read-only. ROM is usually used for BIOS or firmware chip. Hard disk. hard disk is a non-volatile storage medium. Data is not lost during a power failure, which is used to store operating system data and user data in the form of a digital disk. Hard disk allow to divide storage location by partition. For example, the C partition for the operating system, software, and games, and the D partition for user files such as music, videos, and documents. Hard drives are also called HDDs. SSD, or solid-state drive, is a non-volatile storage media with NAND flash technology, which is used as a replacement for HDD. NAND flash technology that replaces digital plates makes SSDs faster, stronger, and more energy efficient. NVMe. NVMe is a non-volatile storage media with NAND flash technology from SSD that uses a PCI Express port and is used as a substitute for regular SSDs for faster performance. This port is usually used for graphics or VGA or sound card. So NVMe technology can provide maximum performance from NAND flash storage media. NVMe is often used on data center or server computers. Next up is the electrical hardware. To work, a computer system requires a stable power and voltage intake. The computer system uses a power supply for management of electricity to each of the other hardware device. In addition, user usually install a star volt to stabilize the electricity, then enters the computer system before it is regulated by the power supply. The power supply is a computer hardware that functions to convert the voltage from AC to DC, so that management can be carried out to the related computer system. And the last is UPS. UPS or uninterruptible power supply is hardware that provides backup electricity as an alternative when the power goes out. This helps users to shut down the computer properly as a measure to prevent data corruption during a power failure. Today, UPS is usually equipped with a stabilizer system so that UPS no longer requires a star volt. However, UPS cost more than star volt. Alright, finally I have finished giving an explanation of storage hardware and electricity. That's all from me. I return it to the moderator, Vita Rahayu.
Okay guys, thank you very much Widya Rahmawati, Sinta Nurfarida, and Sri Rustika for the presentation that has been very quality and comforting. Okay everyone, finally this discussion is over. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.